fellow brothers and sisters, peace be with you.
今天晚上，我们要一起来查考利未记。
Tonight we will study the book of Leviticus together.
要用神圣洁的国度做主题，跟他来走一遍我们的利未记。
So with the topic, the Holy Kingdom of God, we will go through the book on a high level.
是这个利未记啊。那因为我们现在读经进度已经读到利未记。
So for our Bible study schedule, has been brought us to the book of Leviticus.
那从星期三开始读第一章，我们昨天在家庭聚会的时候查考第二章。
So starting on Wednesday, we have studied Leviticus chapter 1. Last night, Thursday night Bible study, we have shared and studied the second chapter.
今天应该要读第三章。
So today we are reading the third.
那因为利未记基本上对一般弟兄姐妹来说，觉得说这个书很枯燥，所以很多人呢都不想读，跳过去了。
So for most members, we may feel that this book is pretty dry, and oftentimes we will skip over it.
但其实，在整个律法里面，这一卷书跟我们的生活其实是关系最密切的。
But throughout the five books of law, this very book has the most applications to our daily lives.
在这里面，对主耶稣基督的预表也是最清楚的。
And the prefiguration of Christ also is found in many places within this book.
所以利未记基本上我们其实要用心的去读。
So in fact, we must study this book in detail.
那因为我们如果弟兄姐妹一起读，我们一起分享。我们可能会更了解，就是会获得更多的信息。
And as our brothers and sisters study this book together and share amongst each other, we may receive more insights.
我们请看翻开利未记第一章第一节。
Let's turn to Leviticus chapter 1 verse 1.
利未记一章一节。
Chapter 1 verse 1.
神从会幕中呼叫摩西，对他说。
Now the Lord called to Moses and spoke to him from the tabernacle of meeting.
这里一开始就说神呼叫摩西。
So right in the start of the chapter, God has spoken to Moses.
这个神呼叫这个词呢，就是希伯来文圣经利未记的这个书名，他们叫做神呼叫。
So the Lord called. This phrase is actually the word Leviticus.Means the Lord calls.
在希伯来文的圣经里面，这一卷书叫做神呼叫。
In the Hebrew scripture, this book, the book of Leviticus, is called the Lord called.
那就是因为这第一章的第一节这第一段话这个词，所以他用这一个词来做书名的。
It is because the book starts off with this phrase, "Now the Lord called."
我们现在的利未记这个名称是。从希伯来文圣经翻译成希腊文圣经，所谓的七十四译本里面，根据这一卷书里面所在谈的内容，基本上都跟利未人有关系，所以我们把它称作利未记。
So later on, we named this book the Book of Leviticus because the book detailed many ceremonial laws regarding the Levites.
那这一卷书基本上他所谈的，如果是关于利未人，那么就是跟在圣殿里面侍奉神的事情有关系的。
So whatever with regards to the Levites, it has something to do with worshiping God in the tabernacle.
因为利未就是神特别选出来要代替以色列众百姓在神的圣殿服侍神的那个支派。
For the tribe of Levi was specially chosen out of the 12 to serve God.
那这个利未记本身它讲有关于敬拜神的事，它有一个主题。
So there is a theme throughout the book in regards to worshiping God.
这个主题我们现在看第十一章。
So let's turn to chapter 11.
我们先看第十一章。
Chapter 11.
第四十四节。
Chapter 11 verse 44.
十一章四十四节说：“我是主你们的神，所以你们要成为圣洁，因为我是圣洁的。你们也不可在地上的爬物污秽自己。”
Verse 44, for I am the Lord your God, you shall therefore consecrate yourself, and you shall be holy, for I am holy. neither shall you defy yourself with any creeping thing that creeps on the earth.
45节说，我是把你们从埃及地领出来的主，要做你们的神，所以你们要圣洁，因为我是圣洁的。
Verse 45, for I am the Lord who brings you up out of the land of Egypt to be your God. You shall therefore be holy, for I am holy.
这两节圣经呢，重复一句话，就是你们要成为圣洁，因为我是圣洁的。
So the two verse repeats, be holy, you shall be holy, for I am holy.
所以整个利未记它基本上所讲的重点就是要成为神圣洁的国民。
So the focus of this book is to be a holy nation of God.
那要让人了解神是圣洁的，所以他的很多的事情，很多的神的吩咐都特别强调说这是神说的。
And in order for men to understand that God is holy, these laws, these instructions were especially given to them by God.
那这个神他宣告他圣洁的属性呢，在第十九章、二十章重复出现。
So in chapter 19 and 20, it recurs the theme thatholiness is one of the features of God.
那所以这个的重点，这个整个利未记的主题就是圣洁。
So the focus of this entire book is holiness.
那为什么是要成为圣洁？
So why should we be holy?
因为神是圣洁的。
For the Lord is holy.
那么神的国度呢，称为圣洁的国度。
And the kingdom of God is a kingdom of holiness.
那神在出埃及记第十九章这样子告诉以色列百姓。
In Exodus chapter 19, the Lord said to his people.
我们先看出埃及记十九章的第六节。
Exodus chapter 19, verse 6.
十九章第六节说：“你们要归我做祭司的国度，成为圣洁的国民。”这些话你要告诉以色列人。
Verse 6, and you shall be to me a kingdom of priests and a holy nation. These are the words which you shall speak to the children of Israel.
神本身是圣洁的神。
God is a holy God.
他要他的百姓成为圣洁的国民。
And he requires his people to be a nation of holiness.
那这个圣洁的国民所组成神的国度，叫做祭司的国度。
And the kingdom of God comprises of a group of holy people, and they are a nation of priests.
那这个祭司的国度在属肉的以色列百姓，这是神一开始把他们从埃及领出来的时候给他们的目标，要成为祭司圣洁的国度。
So to be a holy nation, a kingdom of priests, this was the goal set for the Israelites by God.
那旧约圣经其实是个影子，真正的实体，就是真正的重点，在讲主耶稣基督来到以后所建立的这个教会的国度。
But the Old Testament is merely a shadow. The spirit of these books is to prefigure Lord Jesus Christ, who will come and establish His own holy kingdom.
所以这个神的国度，神选民所组成的这个特殊的国度啊，今天就是我们今天属耶稣基督的每一个人所应当追求的。
So to be a member of this holy nation is something that everyone of us should strive to pursue.
我们现在请看他这个连结性，从彼得前书第二章。
So let's see the connection from First Peter chapter 2.
彼得前书第二章
First Peter chapter 2
第二章我们请看第五节
Chapter 2 verse 5
彼得前书二章五节，你们来到主面前，也就像活石被建造成为灵宫，做圣洁的祭司，借着耶稣基督奉献神所悦纳的灵祭。
Verse 5, you also as living stones are being built upa spiritual house, a holy priesthood, to offer up spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ.
所以我们今天呢，被神拣选，神所宝贵的这些人呢，要成为圣洁的祭司。
So as chosen people by God, we shall strive to be a whole nation of holy priesthood.
那所以这个圣洁祭司就是要奉献神所悦纳的灵祭，就是要献祭给神，那是让神可以悦纳。
And holy priests offer sacrifices that is acceptable to God.
所以我们每一个人现在 也成为祭司的身份。
So every one of us now holds the status of a priest.
看第二章九节。
Chapter 2 verse 9.
第二章九节说，唯有你们是被拣选的族类，是有君尊的祭司，是圣洁的国度，是属神的子民，要叫你们宣扬那召你们出黑暗入奇妙光明者的美德。
Verse 9, but you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, his own special people, that you may proclaim the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light.
这里强调我们也是被神拣选的。
Here it talks about us being chosen.
我们是有君尊的祭司，是像君王一样的尊贵。
And we are a royal priesthood like a royalty.
但是又是祭司，又是可以亲近神的。
But we are also priests that can draw near to God.
那我们成为神圣洁的国度。
And we shall be a holy nation.
我们是属神的。
And we are His special people.
那重点就是要叫我们能够来宣扬。那召我们出黑暗入奇妙光明者的，就是耶稣基督的美德。
And the purpose is to proclaim on Jesus Christ, who called us out of darkness into light.
啊，所以在从被拣选神所特选的这个国民来看，这里面就有一个这个神救赎的这个重点了。
So with the perspective of a nation being chosen, there is the theme of salvation.
那所以在利未记里面呢？要成为圣洁的祭司，就是要能够成为圣洁的国度，这要经过一个救赎的过程。
So within the book of Leviticus, in order to be a holy priest, there is a process of salvation that one must go through.
所以在利未记里面，他谈很多有关于献祭的这些细节。
So within the book, it talks of many details in regards to offering sacrifice.
其实他就是要强调一个重点，我们要脱离罪。
But the main focus is that we need to depart away from sin.
那我们现在看回来利未记第十六章。
Leviticus chapter 16.
利未记第十六章。
Leviticus chapter 16.
我们现在请看第三十节。
Chapter 16 verse 30.
三十节说，因为在这日要为你们赎罪，使你们圣洁净，你们要在神面前。得以洁净，脱尽一切的罪愆。
For on that day the priests shall make atonement for you to cleanse you, that you may be clean from all your sins before the Lord.
好，那现在我们现在看跳过去看第三十四节。
Verse 34。
三十四节这里说，这要做你们永远的定例，就是因以色列人一切的罪，在要一年一度为他们赎罪。于是亚伦照神所吩咐摩西的行了。
34. This shall be an everlasting statute for you to make atonement for the children of Israel for all their sins once a year.
那所以这里提到这个要赎罪，要让人脱离所有的一切的罪愆呢。
So here talks about atonement, washing away of sins.
所以圣洁啊，要成为神圣洁的国度啊。一定要经过赎罪这个过程。
So in order to be a holy nation or holy kingdom of God, one must go through the process of atonement.
这是为什么？这个利未记他一开始的时候，他就开始讲献祭。
So that is why in the beginning of the book it talks of offering sacrifices.
他现在都还没有跟我们讲到这个圣洁的主题以前，他就先开始讲这个五个祭要怎么献。
Before the book.Reveal the focus of being holy. It starts off by telling us how to offer sacrifice.
然后利未记讲到最后的时候，讲到要守神的节期，在那个节期里面充满喜乐。
And towards the end, it talks about observing the feasts, and in observing the feasts, we will be filled with joy.
我们如果从这三个层面来看，就看到利未记三个主题。
So from these three topics, we can see the three themes of the book.
就是他要能够侍奉神，要经过献祭这个过程，这个赎罪这个过程。
So in order to serve God, one must go through the process of sacrifice.
然后应该说第一个就是我们要成为圣洁，这个是神，这个是一本书的中心思想。
So the first principle of this book is that we must be holy.
然后接下来要经过赎罪这个过程。
And then to go through the process of atonement.
那最后就是在这个赎罪，在整个圣洁国度里面去服侍神，来遵守神所规定的是非常喜乐的。
And afterwards, within this kingdom of God, to perform work for God, and we shall receive joy.
按照神所吩咐的，在哪一个时间做什么事情，什么充满喜乐。
According to the timely this instruction of God to perform a work in a timely matter, such is a joyful thing.
所以我们就看到三个重点了。
So then we see these three main themes:
圣洁、赎罪、喜乐。
Holiness, atonement, and joyfulness.
那这个这一卷书一共有27章。
So the book has 27 chapters.
我们如果从圣洁跟侍奉神这两个主题一起去看的话，
So if we think, read the book from the perspective of holiness,
我们可以把整卷书分得几个段落。
Then we can separate the whole book into a few sections.
那这个，因为我们在读一卷圣经的时候，如果能够把它分段落，我们对这卷书就比较容易记得它在讲什么。
So when we read the Bible, if we can outline the different sections of the book, then we have a clear idea of the purpose of the book.
我们信主以后，经过几年，有人信主已经好几十年了，有时候我们对一卷书到底在讲什么，我们也不太容易有概念的。
After believing in the Lord for quite a few years, even more than a decade, sometimes when we read Bible, we are not entirely clear on what's the purpose of the book.
那可能是因为我们读圣经的时候没有抓住那个重点，没有接住要领。
And it could be that we have not grasped the focus of the book.
所以一卷书它的分段其实很重要的。
So the outline of each book is very important.
我们现在这卷书如果很重要的话，我们一定要知道它在讲什么。
So if the book is important, then we must understand what the purpose of the book is.
因为它中心思想是讲圣洁，所以我们现在从圣洁来看这个神怎么把这卷书把它分段了。
And since the focus is holiness, let us see how God had divided the sections in this book.
从第一章到第十章呢，基本上他在讲我们要亲近神，要侍奉神，应该要圣洁。
So from chapter 1 to chapter 10, it talks about drawing near to God and serving God.
所以这个是第一个段落。
And in order to do that, we need to be holy. And this is the first section.
他这里面就讲到要亲近神，要经过献祭这个过程。
And in order to draw near to God, we must first offer sacrifice.
那要侍奉神的人，这个就是成为祭司的，在神的殿里面服侍神的人，要成为圣洁。
And those who serve God in the temple as priests, these people need to be holy.
所以一章到十章，他要讲献祭，讲祭司要成为圣洁的要求。
So from chapter 1 to chapter 10 talks about offering sacrifices and the requirements of holiness for the priests.
然后从十一章到第十六章。
So then from chapter 11 to 16,
这是第二段,
this is the second section.
在讲饮食跟我们身体的圣洁。
It talks about food and drink and the bodily cleanliness.
就是神很重视圣洁，神很重视我们人内心的圣洁。
The Lord place emphasis in the cleanliness of our hearts.
因为神本身就是圣洁的。
For God himself is holy.
那神是灵，所以他看的是人的内心。
For God is a spirit, and He sees the heart of man.
但是神在重视人的内心圣洁的同时，他并没有忽略人在生活上、在行为上应该要圣洁。
So while God placed emphasis on the spiritual cleanliness, He did not disregard the physical hygiene.
那包括我们所吃的食物跟我们个人的身体的卫生观念会影响到我们内心的圣洁。
Including the food and the eating diets that or eating habits we have that can have influences in our inner holiness.
所以第二段里面从十一章到第十六章啊，它第十一章就开始讲饮食。
So starting from chapter 11, it talks about food.
要让我们在饮食上能够分别为圣。
So that we may discern what is clean and what is unclean.
我们现在看一节圣经节，看第十一章。
So let's read chapter 11.
第十一章四十三节。
Chapter 11, verse 43.
这个我们刚才已经读过四十节，我们现在读四十三节。
So read verse 40. Let's read 43.
四十三节说，你们不可因什么爬物使自己成为可憎的，也不可因这些使自己不洁净，以至于染了污秽。
43. You shall not make yourself abominable with any creeping thing that creeps, nor shall you make yourself unclean with them.
第四十七节。
47.
要把洁净的和不洁净的，可吃的与不可吃的活物都分别出来。
To distinguish between the unclean and the clean, and between the animal that may be eaten and the animal that may not be eaten.
这里提到说要分别为圣，包括吃的也要这样做。
He talks about discernment and consecration of food.
然后接下来从第十二章开始。
And then starting chapter 12,
一直到第十五章
，chapter 12 to chapter 15。
那这里面都是在讲有关于身体的洁净的条例，就是身体要怎么样处理，让它身体是保持洁净的。
Here talks about the hygienic laws and the instruction to keep our body clean。
那十二重点就是要让我们跟污秽隔绝了。
And the focus is so that we may depart away from uncleanness.
那这一段里面有一节经节可以代表，看第十五章。
And a single verse can represent this whole section. Let's read chapter 15.
十五章三十一节。
Chapter 15, verse 31.
十五章三十一节。
31.
你们要这样使以色列人与他们的污秽隔绝，免得他们玷污我的帐幕，就因自己的污秽死亡。
So you want this, you shall separate the children of Israel from their uncleanness, lest they die in their uncleanness when they defy my tabernacle that is among them.
So you 看到12, 13, 14, 15章呢，他都在讲这个有关于身体的洁净部分了。
So from chapter 12 to 15 talks about bodily cleanliness.
然后到第十六章，他特别讲了一个很重要的节日。
And by chapter 16, it talks about a very important day.
就是所谓的赎罪日。
And it's the Day of Atonement.
那这个赎罪日呢，就是一年一度要把所有不洁净的，不管是人的、物的、土地的，全部把它一次把它解决，都把它洁净干净。
And on this day, all of the uncleanliness, whether it be bodily uncleanliness or uncleanliness of items or of land, they shall be the uncleanliness shall be removed all within this day.
所以这是第二段，从十一章到第十六章。
So this is the second section from chapter 11 to 16.
第三段就是从十七章到二十章。
And the third section is from 17 to 20.
这在讲生活上的圣洁。
Here talks about purity in our daily lives.
那这个生活上的圣洁就包括他们在宰杀牲畜的时候，特别是要献祭给神的时候要怎么处理。
And talks about how the process should be when we offer cattle to the Lord.
那个百姓他们在献祭的时候，有时候是可以享受这个祭物的。
For some of the sacrifices, the offer shall partake of the offering.
在献祭里面，基本上大部分的祭，五个祭里面有四个祭都是跟宰杀牲畜有关系。
So among the five sacrifices, four of them have to do with offering animals as sacrifice.
所以十七节一开十七章就开始强调这个血不可以吃。
So starting from 17 talks about that we should not eat blood.
所以十七章的十节到第十八节这整段呢，到十六节啊，这整段基本上就会谈不可以吃血的理由。
So starting from chapter 17 verse 10, verse 10 to 16 talks about why we shall not eat blood.
因为这个血是用来献祭的。
For the blood is meant for sacrifice.
血是有动物的生命。
The blood represents the life of the animal.
所以这个生命是用来用这个血就是生命是用来赎罪的。
So life is for the purpose of atonement.
就不可以拿来当作食物来吃。
And therefore, we shall not use it as food to eat.
所以神特别吩咐说，他没有把动物的血赐给人吃。
So God particularly instructed the Israelites that the blood was are not meant for you to eat.
所以他禁止百姓不要吃血的东西。
But He forbade the people to eat blood.
那他这个第十七章之后，第十八章开始呢，都是有关于人际关系上面的圣洁了，跟人相处的。
And so starting from verse chapter 18 talks about personal relationship and how to keep a holy relationship.
所以从十八章、十九章、二十章这三章里面呢，他在讲这个婚姻上的圣洁。
So starting from 18 to 20 talks about cleanliness in marriage.
在家庭伦理上、人际关系上。
And with regards to our family and the moral laws.
在这个我们跟人之间的相处，一定要尊重神，要能够过着这个和谐圣洁的生活。
So we must live in harmony and a holiness among men.
那在这个生活上的要求，这个生活上的圣洁里面， 这里面特别强调几个重点。
And among the requirements of our daily living, there is one focus.
就是说不可以效法当地人的风俗，或者是以前他们在埃及的风俗。
That is not to be conformed with the practices or the traditions of the other people.
我们现在看十八章的第二节。
Let's read chapter 18, verse 2.
第二节说，你小以色列人说，我是主你们的神。三节。
Three.
你们从前住的埃及地，那里的人的行为，你们不可效法。我要领你们到的迦南地，那里人的行为也不可效法，也不可照他们的风俗行。来读一下。
Chapter 18, verse 2, speak to the children of Israel and say to them, I am the Lord your God. Verse 3, according to the doings of the land of Egypt where you dwell, you shall not do, and according to the doings of the land of Canaan where I am bringing you, you shall not do, nor shall you walk in their ordinance.
第四节说，你们要遵我的典章，守我的律例，按此而行，我是主你们的神。
Verse 4, you shall observe my judgment and keep my ordinance to walk in them. I am the Lord your God.
五节说，所以你们要守我的律例典章，人若遵行，就必因此活着。我是神。
Verse 5, you shall therefore keep my statutes and my judgments, which if a man does, he shall live by them.
所以这里强调说，不可以照那个。没有信，没有不是神选民的人的风俗去行了。
So here a stress is not to follow the customs and the practices of the Gentiles.
那知道那些迦南人或者是埃及人他们的风俗里面有一项很让神很厌恶的，就是在这个婚姻上的这个淫乱的行为。
So among the customs of the Egyptians and the Canaanites is the sexual immorality among the people.
第二十十八章的第二十四节开始到三十节，要讲这个神禁戒的百姓不可以去犯淫乱的事。
So starting from chapter 18, verse 24, it forbids the people from sexual impurity.
因为他们这个淫乱呢，让这个地啊，连那个土地都被污染、玷污了。
So because of their immorality, even the land will be defiled.
我们看第二十五节
，verse 25。
他说：“连地也玷污了，所以我追讨那地的罪孽，那地也吐出他的居民。”
For the land is defiled, therefore I visit the punishment of this iniquity upon it, and the land vomits out its inhabitants.
看二十七节
，verse 24。
那在你们以先居住那地的人行了这一切可憎恶的事，地就玷污了。
For all these abominations the men of the land have done who were before you, and thus the land is defiled.
我们看二十三十节
，verse 30。
他所以你们要守我所吩咐的，免得你们听从那些可憎的恶俗，就是在你们以先的人所常行的，以致玷污了自己。我是主你们的神。
Therefore you shall keep my ordinance so that you do not commit any of these abominable customs which were committed before you, and that you do not defile yourself by them. I am the Lord your God.
我们说现在的世代是一个罪恶淫乱的世代。
We talk about this generation as a sinful generation.
在西方这个很发展的国家里面呢，这个淫乱的事已经很稀松平常了。
In the developed Western society, the sexual immoralities are very common nowadays.
其实这一股淫乱的这个歪风啊，已经吹到全世界各地去了。
And this immoral custom has been accepted across the globe.
那其实你看，我们今天在这个社会，是这个传道书说，日光之下没有新鲜事的哈。
So the book of Ecclesiastes says that under the sun there are no new events.
其实在几千年前，这个选民所居住的那个地方啊，就已经充满淫乱的事情了。
Even thousands of years ago, among the land that the chosen people dwell, there are sexual immoral events.
你看那个第十八章里面所描述的这个这些要小心的事情，就是当地人都在行的，所以他特别交代说不可以这样做。
These are the customs practiced by the Gentiles amongst the chosen people, and chapter 18 warns the Israelites of them.
所以这个神的特别的吩咐，对我们今天来说是一个很重要的提醒。
So this special instruction from God serves as an important reminder for us.
那神对他的百姓有这个圣洁的要求，其实基于他自己本身圣洁的属性而来的。
And these requirements of holiness are placed on the chosen people because God Himself has this attribute of holiness.
所以你看第十九章的第二节， 第二十九章第二节那里，你晓谕以色列全会中说：“你们要圣洁，因为我主你们的神是圣洁的。”
Therefore, in chapter 19, verse 2, speak to all the congregation of the children of Israel and say to them, "You shall be holy, for I am Lord your God, am holy."
在第十九章里面呢，一连十六次一直强调我是神。
So within the chapter 19, there are a total of 16 times stressing that the Lord is holy.
那我是神，意思说神是圣洁的神。
And I am God, and I the and God am holy.
这个就是神本身，他是圣洁，所以他要求属他的百姓也要这样做。
And because He Himself is holy, therefore He requires of His people to be holy.
然后，只要如果我们能够成为圣洁，我们就跟这个万民有分别了。
And if we can establish ourselves as holy, then we are consecrated and separated away from the Gentiles.
我们现在看二十章的第二十节。
Let's read chapter
26节。26节。
Chapter 20, verse 26.
二十章的二十六节
，Chapter 20, verse 26。
你们要归我为圣，因为我主是圣的，并叫你们与万民有分别，使你们做我的民。
26, and you shall be holy to me, for I am the Lord, for I the Lord am holy, and have separated you from the peoples that you should be mine.
好，所以从十七章到二十章，这个重点就是生活上的圣洁，特别强调一定要跟万民。跟其他不属神的人有分别。
So starting from chapter 17 to chapter 20 stresses the holiness in our daily lives, and it shall separate us from the Gentiles.
然后从二十一章开始到二十二章这两章呢，在讲有关于神的，在神圣殿服侍神的工人、神的仆人、祭司呢，要圣洁，而且要对这些神的有关于神的事情要特别有态度。
So chapter 21 and 22 talks about the requirement of holiness for priests serving in the temple and the correct attitude that they should have.
因为侍奉神这件事情呢，要按照神所指示的方法。
For in serving God, we must serve under the process or the instruction of God.
神很愿意人来亲近他，但是要按照他的方法。
The Lord wills our men to come and serve Him, but they shall serve according to His methods.
那现在神兴起的他所谓的这个祭司的这个职分呢，给一些他特选的人。
Now the status of priests are given to the specially chosen.
那就是站在神跟人之间来做中保，来代替百姓做献祭给神这个工作。
And they stand between God and men as mediators and performing sacrifices to reconcile men and God.
而且这个祭司，这个神跟人之间的中保，要教导百姓有关于神的律法。
And this mediator shall also teach the people of the laws given by God.
要替百姓来祈求，替百姓来感谢。
They should pray on behalf of the people and offer thanks on their behalf.
照着神的方法，奉献各样的祭物来讨神喜悦。
And according to the methods of God to offer different sacrifices to please Him.
那既然这样，这样一个工人，他负担这么样的工作，这么重要的工作，所以神对他就有特别严格的要求跟训练了。
And since these people serve these very important roles, therefore special requirements are placed on them.
所以这两章里面，他讲有关于祭司对祭司的特别要求。
So these two chapters talks about the requirements of a priest.
那这两章我们在读的时候，一定要看到是我自己神对我的要求。
So when we read these two chapters, we must see ourselves as being required of.
我们在读这一章，在这一卷书的时候，我们都要用我自己是祭司的角度去读这卷书。
When we read this entire book, we must read it considering ourselves as a priest.
不要为传道读圣经了。
Do not read the Bible on behalf of the pastor.
不要为负责人长老执事读圣经。
Or on behalf of the elders, the deacons, or the council members.
要让我们自己本身是站在祭司的角度里面去读这一卷书，神对我们的提醒。
Let us stand in the shoes of a priest to read this book.
那神要我们做什么？
And what does the Lord require of us?
所以我们刚才在彼得前书二章九节已经讲到，已经看过了。我们是今天是有君尊的祭司。
So in Peter, First Peter chapter 2 verse 9, we've already read that we are a royal priesthood.
那我们今天其实要追求的是主耶稣基督所告诉我们的，我们要追求主耶稣所说的，我们的义要超过，其实要超过这个祭司在这里所记载的义。
But the instruction of Jesus is that our righteousness must surpass the righteousness of the priests.
我们一定要。不但要照这个律法神所规定来做，甚至我们要真的从心里面 看到神律法的要求，而且他看到神圣洁的重点，我们什么事情都要从心里面做起。
Not only do we observe all of the laws and statutes of the Old Testament, but we should be able to see the spirit and the reason behind them.
那这一段里面，我们看一节圣经，看22章的第31节。
So let's read chapter 22 verse 31.
22章的31节。
Chapter 22 verse 31.
说你们要谨守遵行我的诫命，我是主。
31. Therefore, you shall keep my commandments and perform them. I am the Lord.
32节说你们不可以亵渎我的圣名，我在以色列人中，却要被尊为圣。我是叫你们成圣的神。
32. You shall not profane my holy name, but I will be hallowed among the children of Israel. I am the Lord who sanctifies you.
33节把你们从埃及地领出来做你们的神，我是主神。
33. Who brought you out of the land of Egypt to be your God? I am the Lord.
今天我们每一个人其实都是神从黑暗罪恶权势里面拯救出来的。
What every one of us have been saved out of the boundaries of darkness.
就好像是百姓从埃及地，神把他领出来。
Just as the people were led out of Egypt.
神要做我们的神。
God will be our God.
所以我们要听他的话。
So we should listen to him.
那我们神就要在我们身上被荣耀，然后我们要尊他为圣。
And then the name of God will be glorified, and we shall worship him as holy.
因为他要求我们成为圣洁。
For he requires holiness of us.
好，那从第最后一段就从23章到27章。
And the last section falls in chapter 23 to 27.
那这一段呢，就是讲有关于节期的圣洁。
And these chapters talks about cleanliness or holiness in the feasts.
那最后有侍奉神的喜乐。
And in the end, we shall enjoy the joyfulness in serving God.
那23章开始就讲很多一些节日、特殊的日子。
So starting 23 talks about special festivals.
那这些特殊的日子是神特选的，是神指定的。
And these feasts are especially defined by God.
那这个神指定的这些日子，就是神跟人要一同来过很喜乐的这个特殊的时光。
And on these days, God and men shall enjoy together this special moment.
所以大家聚在一起，全民大家一起聚在一起的时候，这个就是生活上的交集。
And then, so when the people gather together, it is the time to interact and social.
所以我们现在我们每一天的日子里面有一些特殊的日子，神特别把它分别出来。
So in our daily lives, there are a few special days that are particularly defined.
平常我们每个人都在过自己忙碌的生活。
Normally we live our own busy lives.
但是神指定了一些特殊的日子，众人把世界的事情放下来，一起到神所指定的地方来这里享受神人共乐的美好时光。
But on these appointed times, all of the members will put down their daily work to come together and to enjoy this quality time with God.
那目的就是要叫神能够纪念神给他们的恩惠。
And the purpose is so that they may remember the grace given to them by God.
那神给他们拯救的这个大恩典，以及神赐给他们丰富的饮食，神的百姓绝对没有缺乏的。
The amazing grace of salvation and the daily supplies of their and the sustains of their life.
那在这些日子里面，一方面他们借着献祭来亲近神，也来感谢神。
And in these days, they offer thanksgiving to God by sacrifice and also draw near to God in this way.
那一方面他们也借着献祭来求神赦免他们隐而未现的过错。
They also offer sacrifices for God to wash away the sins that they do not know.
那在这些特殊的日子里面，神借着他的祭司来宣讲神的律法，让百姓更认识神，更知道神所要求的。
In these special appointed times, the priests will also proclaim the laws and the statute of God, so the people may understand God more.
然后众百姓大家共同有个目标来遵行神所吩咐的，然后让全体的这个国度都能够享受神所赐的福乐，然后在里面来荣耀神。
And all the people strive forward to please and meet God's requirements and expectations, and all of them would enjoy a joyful time together as a kingdom of God.
所以这些特殊的节日里面，其实它所表达的就是神要让我们属神的人在这些日子里面，身心灵都能够蒙福。
So what God wants to tell the people is that these special days are given to them so that their heart and their body and their soul can be blessed and be in rest.
那这些节日里面， 比较特殊，它指出几些特一些特殊的日子的哈。
And so a few special holidays are pointed out.
那就是一开始就讲安息日。
So in to start off, talks about the Sabbath day.
每一周的第七天，这个就是神的安息圣日。
Every seventh day of the week, is the Sabbath day.
在这个安息日，每一周里面要纪念神拯救的恩典。
And in every week on this day, the people shall remember the salvation of God.
同时也要纪念神伟大的创造。
And also to remember the miraculous creation of God.
因为如果没有神的创造，我们今天就没有这个环境可以生活。
For without the creation, we do not have an environment to dwell in.
如果我们没有神的拯救，我们今天也不知道要在这一天能够休息，然后享受神的福气。
If it were not for the salvation of God, and we do not have the Sabbath day to rest and to remember the Lord.
那借着守安息日来进一步的向世人表明，我们是属神的。我们今天拥有这一个安息日的证据。
And through observing the Sabbath, we may show that we belong to God, and we have this proof of observance.
哦，所以这个是安息日，每一周的。
So this is the weekly Sabbath.
然后每一个月，它也有所谓的月朔。
And every week.
哦，每个月的哈，有一个月初，第一初一的时候。
And every first day of the month.
那这个在利未记里面呢，它这个月有关的月朔呢，它只有很简单的讲到一次而已。
This observance was briefly mentioned.
因为它在讲到七月的时候，因为这个跟赎罪日有关系，所以它特别只有讲到七月的月朔。
So because on the seventh, the first day of the seventh month, has to do with atonement, so it especially mentions it.
我们看看二十三章的第二十四节
，Chapter 23, verse 24。
二十四节这里说：“你晓谕以色列人说，七月初一你们要守为圣安息日，要吹角做纪念，当有盛会。”
Speak to the children of Israel, saying, "In the seventh month, on the first day of the month, you shall have a Sabbath rest, a memorial of blowing of trumpets, a holy convocation."
这是初七月初一号。这个初一的时候，特别他说把它当作圣安息日来守哦。
So this first day of the seventh month shall be observed as a Sabbath day.
那有关于这个部分呢，其实我们要看民数记二十八章才比较清楚。
So we must refer to Numbers chapter 28 for details.
我们现在请看民数记二十八章。
Numbers chapter 28.
二十八章，请看第十一节。
28 verse 11.
二十八章十一节。
Chapter 28 verse 11.
这个就是讲到。每月朔，你们要将两只公牛犊，一只公绵羊，七只没有残疾一岁的公羊羔，献给主为燔祭。
At the beginning of your months, you shall present a burnt offering to the Lord: two young bulls, one ram, and seven lambs in their first year without blemish.
其实这个就是每个月的月初他们要做的。
So this is something that must be performed at the beginning of every month.
但是特别在第七月的时候，因为七月的十四号有一个七月的时候有一个赎罪日啊。
But because on the 14th day of
第十天初十啊，第十。
At the 10th day of the seventh month, there is a day of atonement.
那个是全国的大日。
And that is a important day for the whole nation.
要让所有的百姓、所有的国家啊，就整个国家、所有的人民、土地都得到洁净的一天呢。
And it is the day where the whole nation and every member of the nation, including the land, shall be cleansed.
啊，所以其实每个月的月初，他们要守月朔。
So on the first day of every month, they shall observe a Sabbath rest.
然后说每一年里面有几个节日，它特别的。
And within every year, there are a few special holidays.
所以如果是看利未记二十三章，你就看到它几个节日，它就写出来。
So starting from Leviticus chapter 23, we will see the different special days.
有逾越节之后有无酵节。
After Passover, there is the feast of unleavened bread.
然后之后有这个七夕节、收割节。
And the day of the harvest.
然后有祝棚节。
The feast of the tent.
这是每一年的。
And these are yearly events.
然后神给他们的这个节日里面还有特殊的，每多少年有一个特殊的安息年。
And aside from these days, after every few years, they will have a year of jubilee.
所以第 第二十五章，利未记二十五章就讲安息年跟息年。
So in the chapter 25 talks about the seventh year and the jubilee year.
每七年这个土地要休息。
So every 7 years the land shall rest.
每五十年有一个禧年。
And every 50 years shall have a year of jubilee.
那这就是禧年，就是这个是全百姓都得自由的那个大日。
And on this special day, the entire nation shall receive freedom.
啊，其实这个就是神特殊的恩典。
And this is the special grace of God.
那个禧年就是神拯救的，每一个人不管他怎样苦，他怎样做奴隶，到禧年的时候，他可以重新获得自由。
The year of jubilee is the day of salvation from God. Whether you are a slave or you are a master, on that day you shall be freed.
啊，所以这个二十五章里面就讲这个。重要的命令了。
So chapter 25 talks about this special instruction.
然后最后第二十六章就是神对人的应许。
Lastly, chapter 26 talks of the promise of God.
通常神跟人在传讲信息的时候都会讲祝福跟咒诅。
Normally, when God speaks to men, he will talk of blessings or curse.
然后最后二十七章呢，就是讲人对神的许愿。人对神要应该有的心意跟许愿之后应该要做的。
And chapter 27 talks about making vows or oaths to God and the correct attitude to have.
因为人通常在危机的时候很容易的、很自然的想要向神许愿，然后要求神，希望能够神为他做什么事。
Because at the moment of grave danger, it's easily for men to make vows to God.
但是往往有时候事情过后，人就容易忘记了。
But oftentimes after the event had concluded or had passed, people may forget.
所以在二十七章最后就特别强调，人如果向神许愿之后，应该要有的态度。
So chapter 27 talks of after making vows or oath to God, the correct attitude that they should have.
所以这个就是这个整个利未记它的整个轮廓。
And so this outlines the entire book of Leviticus.
那这些段落我们如果能够掌握以后啊。
So once we have a clear understanding of these sections,
我们对这个整个利未记来说，基本上就不会觉得很陌生。
And then we will not feel unfamiliar with the book.
我们知道他在讲什么。
We know what the purpose is.
那有关于第一章到第十章这个献祭的事情里面讲的特别详细。
So from chapter 1 to 10 in regards to offering sacrifice, it was written in detail.
那为什么人需要献祭
？So why do men offer sacrifice？
那其实从这个献祭这个动作本身呢、啊，其实是从人类开始一出第二代的时候就有了。
So this action of offering sacrifices had already existed since the second generation of mankind.
那这个就是借由这个献祭这个动作来表达人愿意亲近神的做法。
So through the performing a sacrifice, it shows the willingness of men to draw near to God.
创世纪第四章就记载这个亚伯跟该隐献祭，人类的第二代他们就用这个献祭这个动作来希望能够得到神的喜悦。
Genesis chapter 4 records the sacrifices of Abel and Cain, in order to please God.
那为什么他们会想到用献祭献动物给神来让神得喜悦？这个动作他们怎么来的
？So how did they came up with the idea of offering cattle or grain to the Lord？
那这件事情应该是从神来的指示的。
For this performing of sacrifice should have come from God.
因为杀动物这件事情，当亚当夏娃犯罪以后，神就做过一次了。
For killing an animal, this act was already performed by God when Adam had sinned.
你看那个亚当夏娃被赶出去的时候，他们是身穿皮衣啊。
So when Adam and Eve were expelled from the garden, they wore the skin of animal.
那这个是神特别的慈爱。
And this is a special mercy of God.
所以这个杀动物，这个表达神对人的关怀。
So killing of animal represents the care of men from God.
其实在这一个动作里面，其实就隐含了以后基督耶稣就是那个代罪的羔羊。
And so from this,
让人才有办法得到神的恩惠。
And this simple action of killing an animal prefigures Jesus Christ and his death.
然后我看到第二代的人，他们就懂得要去杀动物来。 来想要讨神的喜欢呢。
So starting from the second generation, they already knew to offer animals to please God.
所以我们就看到说，其实献祭本身其实也是为了要表达我们想要来对神的感谢。
So the in performing a sacrifice represents us wanting to draw near to God.
然后有时候我们有做一些神不喜悦的事情的时候，我们希望能够借着这个动作来祈求神的赦免。
And sometimes if we have performed wrongs, we want to make sacrifices to represent our hearts of repenting or of regret.
所以你看，在这个利未记里面谈到有很多有关于这个赎罪祭、赎愆祭的事情。
So in the book of Leviticus, it talks about many many offerings of remitting sins.
有时候你看，我们今天说献祭本身有几个重点，就是为了要在表达人愿意亲近神。
So there are a few principles behind the performing of sacrifice. First is to represent man's heart of drawing near to God.
来表达人想要奉献给神。
To represent the heart and the willingness to offer to God.
那就是要表达对神的感谢。
And that is to represent thanksgiving towards God.
然后祈求神的赦免。
And asking of God's forgiveness.
那神是圣洁的了哈。
God is holy.
但人往往是趋向于跟神敌对的。
But men oftentimes lean towards the opposition.
那是因为人这个罪性，这个犯罪以后，这个罪性进入人的心里面以后，这个就是人很自然会做的事了。
And that is due to the sinful nature of men that happened after men had sinned.
所以有时候。我们有时候会做一些事情是神说不可以做的事。
So oftentimes we will do deeds that are already forbade by God.
所以献祭就是很重要一部分，就是为了赎罪。
So offering sacrifices is to make atonement.
我们现在看第四章利未记第四章二节。
So let's read Leviticus chapter 4 verse 2.
四章二节说，你要晓以色列人说，若有人在神所吩咐不可行的什么事上误犯了一件。
Chapter 2, speak to the children of Israel, saying, if a person sins unintentionally against any of the commandments of the Lord.
就是说，神说不可以做的，但是不小心去犯了。
So commandments given by God to forbid us from doing, but we intentionally committed.
祭司虽然是当神跟人之间的中保，但是祭司也可能犯错，也可能是不小心去犯了神说不可以犯。
Although the priests are the mediator between God and men, but it is easy for priests to unintentionally commit sin.
在这个五祭里面，赎罪祭讲的特别长，讲的特别清楚。
Among the five offerings, the sin offering was described in length and in detail.
他一开始先讲祭司如果犯罪怎么办。
He talks about what happens when a priest sins.
然后之后看第十五节，十三节。
Read chapter 13.
如果是全会众犯罪，或者是隐而未现的，不知道说这个做这件事情是神不喜悦的。
If the entire congregation has sinned or intentionally sinned, what should the priest do?
十三节说，以色列全会中若行了神所吩咐不可行的什么事，误犯了罪，是隐而未现的，会众看不出来的。
Now if the whole congregation of Israel sins unintentionally, and the thing is hidden from the eyes of the assembly.
所以有时候众百姓会犯一些他们不知道说这个是不可以的事啊。
So sometimes the entire congregation may commit a sin that they know not it was a sin.
十四节说，会众一知道以后，啊，所犯的罪啊，就要开始献祭了。
So starting verse 14, once they knew of the sin, then they need to start offering sacrifice.
那这个，所以祭司如果犯罪，跟这个全会众犯罪啊，这两个层面哦，这个要赎罪的那个方法都一样。
So the process of offering sacrifices are the same for when a priest sins or when the entire assembly sins.
看第二十二节
，verse 22。
他如果官长犯罪呢？
What if the ruler had sinned?
官长犯了神所吩咐不可行的什么事，误犯了罪。
Had done something unintentionally against any of the commandments of the Lord.
好，那这个也要赎罪。
Then he needs to seek atonement.
只要一知道之后就要赎罪了。
And once he knew of the sin, then he should offer sacrifice.
那个赎罪的方法哈，就比那个祭司还比较简单一点了。
And the process is slightly simpler than that of a priest's sin.
那祭物本身也比较小了。
And the offering the sacrifice itself is lesser.
那最后就是第27节，如果百姓当中有人误犯了错。
Lastly, in 27, if anyone of the common people sins unintentionally,
要怎么办?
Then what needs to be done?
所以在赎罪祭里面就分四个层次。
So, with regards to sin offering, there are four levels.
祭司犯罪，全会众犯罪。
When the priest sins or the entire assembly sins.
官长犯罪，百姓犯罪。
The ruler sins or the common people.
通常他都特别说是误犯，是不知道的。
And it always records it as unintentionally.
知道以后都要赎罪了。
And once they knew of the sin, they need to sacrifice.
所以其实献祭本身很重要的一部分，就是为了要祈求神的赦免。
So in offering sacrifices, we seek the forgiveness of God.
那在这个五祭里面呢、啊，这五个重要祭当中啊，有三个祭是称为馨香的火祭。
So among the five.Offerings, three of them are offerings of fragrance.
哦，就是燔祭、素祭跟平安祭。
There's a burnt offering, a grain offering, and peace offering.
那赎罪祭、赎罪祭就称为所谓的赎罪的祭。赎罪的就是为了要求神赦免的。
So sin offering and trespass offerings are normally called sacrifices of.Forgiveness.
就是就他这个献祭本身的这个意义来说的，他的那个献祭本身他所要表达的意思来说的。
So with and they are named this way in because of the nature and the purpose of the offering.
那如果用祭物本身来分呢、啊，就有所谓的血祭跟素祭，就是有流血的跟没有流血的。
So if we divide the different offerings by the offering item, then there are those that sheds blood and those that don't.
所以五祭里面四个祭。都跟宰杀动物有流血有关系的。
So among the five offerings, four of them has to do with offering cattle.
那素祭就是以谷物啊，以有小麦为制品来献给神的，所以这个就是不流血的。
And in the grain offering, it offers up grain or wheat, and there is no blood in there.
但是通常献祭这个时候，通常这个素祭呢，就是跟这个其他的流血的祭一起献的，所以素祭不可以单独献。
But grain offering should not be offered alone; it must accompany other four.
哦，那所以其实每一个祭物本身，每一个祭本身，它都有主耶稣基督的义表在里面。
And in every one of the five offerings, there is a prefiguration of Christ.
我们在读圣经的时候呢，我们希望能够祷告求神带领，让我们能够看到里面所隐含的基督的预表。
When we pray, let us pray so that we may see the prefiguration when we are reading the Bible.
在今天这个社会里面，今天主耶稣给我们的恩典，其实主耶稣已经把我们这些需要献祭的这些所有的过程都成全了。
In fact, Jesus Christ had already fulfilled all the requirements of these offerings.
但是我们虽然不用去做这些真的杀羊、杀牛的动作，但是我们其实，在属灵里面还是要常常对神献祭的。
Although we need not to offer to perform the physical offering of killing our lambs or cattle, but in our heart we must often offer up sacrifice.
那个重点就是我们要成为在神面前是圣洁的国民。
And the focus and the purpose is so that we may be holy, a holy nation before God.
所以其实我们每一天呢都要自我反省。
So, in fact, every day we must examine ourselves.
我们在这一天里面有任何的过错，一知道以后求神赦免。
Have we committed any sin, any wrong, today? And once we are aware, let us pray for God's forgiveness.
我们如果真的在神面前呢，能够求神，用这个谦卑的心求神呢，圣经说我们的罪会被神赦免的。
If we are able to humble our hearts before God to ask for forgiveness, then surely we will be forgiven.
我们在神面前能够时常成为圣洁的国民。
And we will often be a pure nation before God.
那我们的教会呢，就成为神圣洁的国度。
And our church will be the holy kingdom of God.
那这个国度其实就是神的帐幕在人间，这个 圣洁的国度从天降下来的。
And then our church would become the tabernacle among from heaven among men.
在这个国度里面，我们可以享受神的慈爱，我们有神的恩典，我们也可以在这里面喜乐。
And within this kingdom, we shall enjoy the mercy and the grace of God as well as joy among each other.
主耶稣带领我们，我们来唱诗。
And the Lord lead us. Let us sing Him.
510首。
Let's sing Him number 510.